Hey, I'm Darcy, and welcome to ScreenCasts Online. As is traditional for September, Apple have officially released the next wave of operating systems. By way of simplifying naming across all the products, they've gone away with the previous version numbers and unified them under the year after they're released. Today, we'll be covering watchOS 26, which is the successor to watchOS 11. Presumably, they've named all their operating systems after the next year because they are released so late in the current year. The most noticeable change is to the design language. Apple have made the most significant shift since iOS 7 launched, incorporating a liquid glass effect across the board. You'll come to notice this change more and more throughout the video, and as you interact with it on your own device after updating. As far as the Apple Watch is concerned, the new UI has also brought about major changes to apps like Workout, which we'll be covering first. This is the starting page for the app, and for regular users, you'll already notice a difference. Previously, we would see a list of workouts that we could scroll between, but now it almost looks like there's just one with the options to begin and a few more around the sides. But you can in fact scroll down using your finger or the digital crown to view more exercise types. These include the Fitness Plus exercises, such as narrated walks. We can start by customizing which narrated walk this is by hitting on the ellipsis in the top right corner. Then we can scroll through and see many more narrated walks for anyone subscribed to Fitness Plus. Tapping on the eye will give more information, in this case that the talk duration is 17 minutes with 14 minutes of music, when it was released, and some information about the speaker. I can tap on Browse More here to actually scan through the entire catalog of these narrated walks. I'll use the back button instead and return to our original walk. Now I just want to emphasize that this is the screen you can move between workouts from, noticing that the background changes dynamically between each type. I really wanted to put emphasis on it because it can be a little bit unclear where all your workouts are as they're taking up the full screen. If I keep scrolling down, there are many, many exercises. And at the very bottom, we have the plus button to add more workouts. If I select Add Workout again, I can scroll through a list of different sports. I'll choose cross-country skiing. Now this is added to the very top of my list. If I scroll down, we come back to outdoor walk. This list will rearrange based on how recently you used this exercise type. Now we can get into customizing this individual workout, which also has changed thanks to the new UI. I'll start by clicking on the music icon in the bottom left corner. This provides us with an option to autoplay media. Whenever we start this workout, certain media will play. There are two initial options, picked for you or choose media, which we already have selected. And if I scroll down a little bit, I can tap on add media. This begins with music suggestions, a bunch of different playlists that are traditionally associated with exercise. Scrolling down further shows me my source of music. In my case, I use Apple Music, but you may find other music providers here. And this reveals considerably more playlists that we can choose from. I'll select that media, and it becomes listed at the bottom for us, so we can always see what it is that we're going to be listening to. Alternatively, if I select Picked for You, no music is shown at all. It's going to randomly select from those tracks for you whenever you start a workout. Head back, and we'll click on the icon in the top left corner. This is the new area to customize your workout views. When I scroll down, I see the first panel of information for my workout. Down a little bit further, and I can see the second panel. This new information can be swiped to while you're within a workout. I'll start by changing the information I see in the first panel by tapping on the pencil icon. I can tap on any icon here to change the information, such as pace. Instead of average pace, I'm going to change it to current pace. That change is automatically saved, so I can tap on the X to exit, then move on to the second viewing panel. I still want the option to view my average pace, but I just don't want it on the first screen, so I'll make that adjustment here. Now, each are visible, but more customized to what I prefer. I'll also adjust the calories that I see on this second viewing panel. Instead of the total calories for this workout, I'm going to change it to segment, so I can see how much I've burnt in this part of the workout. Once you're done there, head back again, and make sure to toggle on include, so that it's actually viewable in our workout. You can add even more segments as you scroll down, making sure that as much information as you need is available. I'm all set here, so I'll tap on the arrow, which brings us back to the workout front page. Now tap on the clock icon in the top right corner. This is the new area for customizing goals and targets. Let me tap on goals here. I can begin the workout with a specific goal in mind. I'll edit the first one, calories, again by tapping on the pencil, and I'll tap where it says calories 1000 cal. This is way too big a goal, so I'll adjust this down to something more reasonable. After tapping done to confirm it, I can start the workout from this section, and the entire thing will be centered around how many calories I burn. Once I reach 500, the workout will continue, but it will be complete. The goal will be achieved. The goals are always accessible here, but you can delete them too by scrolling down and tapping on delete. You can also use this area to create a goal around time, how long you're doing the exercise for, or distance, how far you go. If I hit plus at the bottom, I can add a brand new one. And this is handy if you want different goals for different times. For instance, I may want to walk with a lower calorie count, something a bit more gentle. So I'll add that in. If I go back and tap on custom this time, we can actually create a workout with multiple parts. The first section is warm up, and I'll tap on this to customize it further. I want my warm up to be a certain amount of distance, not open or time. 1000 meters is a bit too long, so I'll edit this down to about 500. So in other words, I'll walk 500 meters, and that will be the warm up section. Next, if I tap on add, I can create the actual workout section. I can choose between work, recovery, and repeats. This time I'll select time, and I'll change it to 10 minutes. So I'll be doing work for 10 minutes. Tap on done, and I'll tap on add again. This time we want a recovery section. I'll keep this at 5 minutes. And then if I tap on add once more, I can create repeats. Here it's showing our work and recovery, the ones that we just made. I'll select both of them. Then once I press on the purple arrow, I can indicate how many times I want these to repeat. I'll tap on done once I'm completed here. Then I'll add in a cooldown. I'll keep this open so I can basically just walk until I feel good. I'll create a custom title for this one. I'll just call it walking training. And as I scroll down, I can see the custom views. At the very bottom, I'll tap on create workout. And now we've got a custom one. This can now be accessed back on the categories page, just underneath goals. And we'll go back once more and check out the icon in the bottom right corner. Here we have a brand new feature for watchOS 26, and it's called the Workout Buddy. It does require your Apple Watch to be paired with an iPhone that can handle Apple intelligence, so iPhone 15 Pro and later. The Workout Buddy is a motivational tool. It tracks your workouts in the moment, and a voice provides you with the motivation and information you need to keep going. First thing, I'll turn it on. And then we have the option of choosing the voice that speaks to us. Here's a preview of each of them. We've got voice one.
Way to get your workout started.
Voice two.
Way to get your workout started.
And voice three.
Way to get your workout started.
That's all we need to configure in this section. Below is just some information about what Workout Buddy is. If I go back, I can customize the type of alerts that I'll get from the Workout Buddy. Let me start with heart rate. This is off, so I'll change it to custom range. And beneath this, I can set a lower and higher range. So while I'm doing my workout, if my heart rate goes below 120, I'll get a notification from the Workout Buddy. And the same if it goes higher than 140. So it's keeping me in the right zone. You can get other alerts for a time and for splits. I'll change the splits here to 1 kilometer. So I'll get that extra piece of encouragement every 1K. The next section I can toggle is about our custom workouts. We created one before, and if we have this turned on, we'll also get Workout Buddy notifications based on those custom goals. I'll head back now, and it's time to start our workout by hitting the play button. Because I've done it from this area and not from the custom workouts we viewed before, it's just giving me an open outdoor walk. And you'll notice after a few moments, the music begins to automatically play as well, which we configured earlier. And that's everything that's new in the Workouts app. I thought that it was important to go over it a bit thoroughly because of how much has changed in this space.